Columbia University. I'm Sabrina Isaac from Berry Science Lab. As Andrew can roughly see, we're solving a version, one specific version of math of 5. Number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, number 7, number 7, number 8, number 9, number 10, number 11, number 12, number 13, number 14, number 15, number 16, number 17, gotta turn around, number 18, number 19, number 20, number 21, number 22, number 23, number 24, and as you can see, number 25. Now let's go all the way back to solve all these problems one by one. Now, 4 square root of 3 plus what two numbers make 300? Well, 100 and 3, to be most common specific. But that might help us out. So 4 square root of 3 plus 2 times 10 square root of 3. So that's 4 square root of 3 plus 20 square root of 3, which makes 24 square root of 3. So that's our answer for number 1. So number 2, square root of 7, square root of 7, square root of 42 plus 5 square root of 7. If you need help with the calculations in the 42 and 7, here it is. So 42 and 7, right? So 7 times 2 is 14, 4, 1, and then 7 times 4 is 28, plus 1 more is 29. So it's 294. If you think it 252, that's only for 7 and 49. So we got 194. No, we got 294. So let's go on. So here's the division of 294. Always start with the smallest number. That's the lesson. 2, 147. So 49, 7, 7. So 6, 7. So square root of 6 square root of 49. So 5 times 7, which is 35. So 7 square root of 6 plus 35. Number 3, square root of 2, square root of 98 over 7. Don't be sad, I'm the clear explainer of things I teach. 98. So, 2, 7, 49, and 7, 7. So 2, 7, 7 over 7. So 2, 2, 7. So 2, 7, 7. Y minus cube minus 12x8 y 16. So first we multiply the number 3 times minus 12 is minus 36. X7, X8 make X15. Y minus 3 and Y16 make Y13. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. Then this one is easy too. Number 5. 2X squared. Y6. Z4 whole squared. So 4, 2 squared is 4. 2 times 2 is 4. Y times 6 times Y, 6 times 2 is 12. Z, 4 times 2 is 8. So that's our answer there. Then 17x squared minus 10x plus 19, we distribute the minus the right side, the right side. To help you with the directions, you try using your hands to make L's. The one that makes a perfect L is your left hand, and the one that makes a backward L is your right. So see, that's the right. So, so minus minus plus, if you watch most of my videos, plus 7x squared plus 3x, and then minus plus is minus. 17 plus 7 is 24. 10 minus 10 plus 3 is minus 7. And 19 minus 3 is 16. So that's our answer there. Now comes the tricky part. So we distribute each one by one. Number 7, 3x minus 6, x squared minus 3x plus 3. Distribute one by one. So then, 3x cubed minus 9x squared plus 9x minus 6x squared plus 18x plus 3. I mean minus 18. So 3x cubed minus 15x squared plus 27x minus 18. Don't divide them all by 3. So number 8, divide and conquer. This one might be tricky for some of you, but if you've watched the other two of my Math of 5 videos, then, well, you'll understand this. So, x 18 plus 9x 9 minus 15x 5 over minus 3x 5. So, understand this? We have to do what we said. Minus 6x18 minus 3x5 minus 9x9 over minus 3x5 plus 15x5 over minus 3x over 3x5. Cancel 5. So 9, and then that's minus 3. And then cancel 2. So 2x13 minus 3x4 plus 5. So number 9. 45x squared y minus 20y cubed. So we have to find one common factor that goes to both of these. Well, I found one, and it's 5. That's the simplest number you could think of when you were in pre-K. Yep. 5, y, 45, 9x squared minus 4y squared. So then that will make a short answer for us. Pretty long, like a piece of spaghetti. Wait, no, not too long. 3x squared minus 4, no, 3x minus 4, 2y, 3x plus 2y. So that, now, number 10, 2x squared. 2x squared plus, so the product is 20, sum is minus 1. So there are two numbers that make this, 4 and minus 5. Oh wait, no, minus 4 and plus 5. I am so dumb. So 2x squared minus 4x plus 5x minus 10. So the factors are 2x, then x minus 2, plus 5 x minus 2. So it has, so 2x plus 5 equals to 0, so x equals to 2 minus 2 over 5, 5 over 2, and then x minus 2 goes to 0, x equals to 2. Number 11, 15ax plus 18ay plus 40bx plus 48by. Don't tell me this is a spaghetti vacation of another day. So, 3a is the factor, then 5x plus 6y, then 8 is a factor, 5 plus 8b, 8b, 5x plus 6y. So our answer is 3a plus 8b. No, that's not the spaghettification of this. No, it isn't.
What is the answer? 3a plus 8y and then 5x plus 6y, both. No, don't think about the answer key. We are not thinking about answer key. So write.
That is not more than one answer.
Write in a traditional way. The traditional answer is 3a plus 8b and 5x plus 6y.
Okay, fine. So fine, our traditional answers are 3a plus 8b and 5x plus 6y. Don't think about the answer key. 12. If k represents a number, write the equation. 41 subtracts from 7 times the number is 65. So, 41 subtracted from, so that's minus 41. And then 7 times the number, so that's 7 times k. So if you watch some of my videos, I say things like this: when I multiply 8 and b, I get 8b. So 7 times k is 7k. So 7k minus 41, and the result says 65. So that's our answer. 7k minus 41 equals 65. No more explanation needed. This one, as you can see, is cross multiplication. So, x plus 4 times 15 is 15x plus 60. Well, and then x plus 8 and 9 make 9x plus 72. So, all numbers go to the right side and all variables go to the left side, right? No? Okay. All variables go to the right side. I guess 72 minus 60 is 12. 15 minus 9 is 15 minus 9 is 6. Divide everything by 6. 2. So 2 equals x. If you flip this, it's x equals 2. So that's our answer. So number 14. 8 minus 2x equals to 2 minus 5 minus 4x. So then, wait, no. Write this number third up. Equals to 2 minus 5 minus 4x. There we go. So, we distribute 2 first. So that gives us this. So 8 minus 2x equals 10 minus 10 minus 8x. So that this goes there, so that goes there, and that goes there. So 8 plus 10 equals to 2x minus 8x. So 18 equals to minus 6x. We divide everything by minus 6, that's minus 3. So minus 3 equals x. And if we swap it once again, it's x equals minus 3. So that's our answer. Now we have to solve for y here at 15. Still have 10 more questions to go. And one is triangle. So minus x minus y equals to minus 6 minus 2x plus y equals to minus 3. I used to suffer at this problem, but now I break. Minus y plus y cancel. Minus x minus 2x minus 3x equals to minus 6 minus 3 minus 9. X is 3. So what happens if we plug that into one equation? So minus 3 minus y equals to minus 6. In that case, y has to be 3 also. But what about in this case? Minus 2 times 3 plus y equals to minus 3. So that's minus 6 plus 3 equals to minus 3. Wow, that's also a true case. So y must be the same as x. Y equals to x, which means y should be 3. We're almost getting to the turn here. So my brother is doing the same thing as me, except it's less smarter. Actually, we're almost at the turn here. And as you can see, the last problem is right next to me. But that doesn't mean we're going to do it right away after we solve this one. We have like a certain amount of questions to go. So solve for y. Z equals to 5x plus 8y. First, in most of my videos, I mentioned that only in my math 05. If you want to solve something, you must isolate the thing that is multiplied by it. So, or like possessed by it. Equal to 8y. We divide everything by 8 for extinguishing the thing. So if you swap it, it's y equal to z minus 5x over 8. Sorry, guess it took up too much space. You know, it took up the whole universe made of space around us. Ha ha. So number 17, x squared minus 2x minus 15. Equal to 0. So right now it's 9:26. Use time wisely. Otherwise, they'll close on you. So, x squared. So, two numbers that make minus 15. So this is A, there's an invisible one here. This is B. And this is C. Also, if you don't know the equation, it's minus B plus minus the square root of B squared minus 4AC over 2A. I solve lots of quadratic problems every day, but I only rarely show them to you once I'm on camera. So 2A. So, minus minus plus 2 plus minus the square root of b squared, which is minus 2 squared minus 4ac. So minus 4 times 1 times 15 minus 15 over 2 times 1 is 2. So 2 plus minus is squared of, so 4 minus 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 plus. So 4 plus 60 over 2. So 2 plus minus the square of 64, which is 8 over 2. So 2, the two cases are 10 over 2, which is which is 5, or minus 6 over 2, which results in minus 3. So these are our two answers. So here we are at the turn. Dad, come here.
Okay. Go.
Now we're doing number 18, the triangle problem. So, 3x and 12. At random times, the horizontal and vertical one is A and B, and then the hypotenuse, which is the diagonal line, if you ask me, is C. So, plus b squared equals to c squared. So, a squared, let's say 3 squared plus b squared, let's say it's 12 squared, equal to c squared, which is our unknown squared. So, 3 squared is 9 plus 12 squared is 144, which is 153. So it's a square root of 153. So let's divide that down. 3 down 51. Then down 17. Then that's prime. So 3, 3, 17. So square root of 9 square root of 17. Which is 3 square root of 17. That's our answer for number 18. Number 19. So minus x plus 7 is greater than 5x minus 17. We have to find the inequality. So right, left. So 17 plus 7 is 24, and then minus x plus 5x plus x is 6x. Divide by 6, divide by 6. 4, then cancel x. So that means x, 4 is less than x. So that means bigger than 4. So let's draw this number line. So this is 0. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we'll circle this part, meaning that is greater. So minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and then let's snap into the lower. Squared only sees doing the regions. So 2 squared times minus 2, which is 4 times minus 2. And then a squared b plus b a plus b squared. So a is 2, b is minus 2. We have no c. So a is 2, so 2 squared times minus 2, because b is minus 2, plus minus 2 times 2, plus minus 2 squared. So 4 times minus 2 is minus 8. Excuse me. Plus minus minus 4 plus 4, which is minus 2. So our answer for that one is minus 8, 21. That is going to require a lot of thinking. So 2y, we have to isolate it. So 4 goes to... So it's minus 4x plus 2y equals to 8. We have to put this in graph form. We isolate 2y. Y equals to 4x plus 8. So divide everything by 2 because we want y to be lowly. It's 2, 4. So y equals to 2x plus 4. So the slope is 2 over 1. Anything divided by 1 is anything. Okay? So 2 is rise, 1 is run. So let's make 0 comma 4. If we find y-intercept, make sure x is 0. If we find x-intercept, make sure y is 0. So 1, 2, Don't worry about me not knowing which is which. I already know it. So rise 2 from the origin, 1, 2, and run 1 from the origin, 1. But for that, so this is 4, positive 4. So we go up to 6 and then we run 1. That's our point. So we have to connect these two points together. Find the equation of 9. Minus 6 comma 10 and 5 comma minus 12. So minus 6 comma 10 and 5 comma minus 12 comma minus 12. So x1 y1. So minus 12 plus minus minus plus 10 over. Oh wait, no. So that's minus 10 because there's no minus at the 10. And 5 plus 6, so minus 22 over 11, and it's minus 2. So y equals to minus 2x, minus 2 parentheses, x minus x1. X1 is minus 6 minus minus plus 6, and then plus y1, so plus minus minus. Oh wait, so that's actually plus 10. So y equals to minus 2x minus 12 plus 10. So y equals to minus 2x minus 2. And find the equation of a vertical line minus 9 comma 10. And by vertical line, they mean the horizontal component, x. X is minus 9. So that means this line has 9 and minus 9. So that's our answer. Number
12. Write it. So write it. Find the vertical equal line. So that x equal to minus 9. You write x equal to minus 9.
So that's x equals to minus 9.
Okay.
So 23 this is x, right? We have to find the equation of the vertical line, but now they're talking about the horizontal component, which is x. X is minus 9. So that means they're talking about this line. So x is, well, minus 9.
Yeah.
Now we have to do this. So this is x. So x is minus 9 right here. And if x is minus 9 over there, this has to be the opposite of it. It has to be plus 9. So actually we don't need that. So this is just our answer. Dad, let me get... We're getting close to the end. We have to find the slope and y-intercept of minus 9x plus 2y equals to minus 8. Wait. Minus 2y. Minus 8. Works a lot. So, we have to isolate y again. So, 2y and minus 8 switch places. Minus 9x plus 8. So that swaps. We divide everything by 2, 4. So y equals to minus 9 over 2x plus 4. So our slope is minus 9 over 2. And our y-intercept is 0, 4. So, this is our final problem. Let's take number 25. Find slope of the graph above. So, we're doing 3, 0, because this is x-intercept, and 0, 6, because that's y-intercept. So, six looks like a zero. So, this is y2, so six, and then minus zero over, then this is x2, zero, minus y1 over x2 minus x1, right? This is x1, this is y1, this is x2, this is y2. So y2 is 6 minus y1 is 0 over 0 is x2 minus 3 is x1. So that's 6 over minus 2. Our slope for that is minus 2.
Show from starting from here.
So we've did all the problems from 1 to 25. Bye from Columbia University. And hope you enjoyed this math 5. So don't forget
to action again.
Going to Barry's Science Lab to fall in love with math and science.